very warm welcome to all of you. Myself, Dr. Yashpal Sharma from Central Institute of Education Technology, NCERT, New Delhi. In this module, we will discuss the techno-savvy skills for teachers in higher education. The importance of technology in our daily lives is undeniable. This is due to the fact that in today's dynamic world, life without technology is meaningless. Technology, which basically refers to bringing together tools that ease creation, use, and exchange of information, has a major goal of making tasks easier to execute as well as solving problems in mankind. As technology continues to advance and direct even more easiness in our lives, there is a need to stress how advantageous it has been to our lives. Technology has proven its impact in various fields. In many ways, one such field is education, where a lot of experiments all across the world has been initiated to best use of technology to enhance the quality of education. Education system across the world has seen a spectator paradigm shift from the standard strategies of teaching to digital education approach through technical devices. Technology influences the way we communicate with each other, socialize the things, connecting to each other, playing and learning. Though technology impacting our daily tasks, we must always conjointly make sure the presence of technology within the classroom also. With the advancement of technology, academics should alter their teaching design to stay students engaged in teaching learning by use these technology. What? Just simply adding technology to their class won't solve the problem. The teacher needs to be empowered with best use of technology to moderate various digital or technical activities in a way that enhances education. The best way is to help teachers to adjust themselves with these technologies by imparting training to them and their hand-holding. The teachers should also adapt new technological skills and become tech-savvy. Tech-savvy teachers help to develop a positive environment by engaging students to make learning more enjoyable and engaging. So, let's discuss the various tech-savvy skills that teachers should have for teaching learning, research, management, communication, and for their own professional development. So, first is for teaching and learning. For teaching and learning, e-content is a centric part. E-content has many types of, just like audio, video, image or graphic, document, interactive, and even immersive. So let's first discuss the types of e-content in detail and file types of the particular e-content that we use in our day-to-day life. So first is audio. An audio simply is a term used to describe any sound or noise that is within a range the human ear is capable of hearing. It is measured in hertz and is heard through speakers and headphones. Audio resources like historical speeches are a great source of e-content. Audio system accepts different file types like .mp4, .bav, .bevm, .aec, .amr, .3pg, .m4a, .m4b, .m4p, .ogg, etc. Audio resources can be recorded by using any recording device, even the mobile phone, etc. The second type of content is the video. Video is an electronic medium for the recording, copying, playback, broadcasting, and displaying of moving visual media. Video is the most effective and most usable type of e-content of this generation. Video may have the file type format like BevM, .flb, .mkv, .bov, .ogv, .ogg, .gif, .abi, .mob, .mts, .wmb, .mp4, .mpeg, .3gp, etc. Videos may be in resolution of standard definition or high definition, and even in 4K resolutions also, and can be recorded with video camera, mobile phone, camcorder, can be captured with screencasting devices, or can be developed by using editing softwares. The third type of content is images or graphics. An image is an artifact that depicts visual perception, such as a photograph or other two-dimensional picture that resembles a subject, usually a physical object, and thus provides a depiction of it. Image or graphic is one of the most commonly used e-content type. An image may have the format like .jpg, .jpg, .tiff, .gif, .bmp, .png, .sbg, etc. Images can be captured while using camera or can be created while using different softwares. The next type of content is the document. Literally, a document is a written, drawn, presented, or memorized representation of thought. Since we are talking about e-content form, so we will talk about the soft copy of the document like word processor, PDF, EPUB, etc. Document may have the file format like .doc, .jvu, .html, .xml, .docx, .odt for the open formats, .pdf, .rtf, .doc, etc. Document can be created by using software. The next type of e-content is the interactive. Interactive e-content is a combination of various media like audio, video, document, etc. So sometimes we call it multimedia content. Interactive content is one of the best type of e-content to teach a concept with better understanding. It may include simulations, etc. Interactive content engages a learner and process as per pace of the learner. File format for interactive content depends on the software or portals being used to develop these specific content, as interactive content develops only by using specified software and portals. Like, if we are creating the GeoGebra applets or simulations, they must have the file format .ggb. But some of the dynamic interactives can be converted or ported into HTML format and used on any HTML acceptable platforms like H5P. The next type of content is the immersive content. Immersive content is a new type of content, or we can say the new generation content. It includes the augmented reality, virtual reality, mixed reality, and even the 360 degree content. Immersive content can be developed by using specialized 360 cameras and softwares. The content provides a real feel about the concept, and learner feels to be fully immersed and interact with the subject. So, a tech-savvy teacher should know all these type of content and the correct file type while using the content. The question arises here: from where one get this e-content? Maybe one can develop by him or herself. What majority of us always looking upon the internet. Internet is full of information. What getting reliable information needs tech-savvy skills. We are as netizens spending most of our time on internet for various purposes and uploading, downloading a large number of data per day. Downloading content from the internet for official use or even for personal use may land someone to trouble. Not today, but just today, maybe the next month or the next year, if we don't know the type of license that the content contains. Now, lot of open content for educational and non-commercial use, or even for commercial use, is available on internet. Knowing the proper license is need of the hour. These open licenses are also known as Creative Commons license and depends upon the few conditions. Like, the first condition is attribution, which is represented by BY. The first condition is attribution, which says one has to give attribution to use your work, like giving reference or credit. What? In this case, direct URL of the content will be given where the content is being used. This condition is mandatory for all Creative Commons license and is a part of all the Creative Commons license. If anyone want to use your work without giving the proper credit, they must get your permission first. The second condition might be the share alike. If the content is released under share alike as one of the condition, it lets other to copy, distribute, display, perform, and modify your work as long as they distribute any modified work on the same terms. If content developed by using this license, the final product has to be released under the similar conditions, that's a similar license. Most of the open educational resources comes under this license for wider adaptation and dissemination. The next condition might be non-commercial, that is NC. Under this condition, the content is open to copy, distribute, display, perform, and modify. One can use your work for any purpose other than to commercially exploit it. No one can monetize the content or upload it on any monetized platform. The fourth condition might be no derivative or non-derivative, that is ND. This condition lets others to copy, distribute, display, and perform the only original copies of your work. No one can edit, adapt, or translate the work. They have to use it as such. After compiling these four conditions, we have six type of licenses that we call the Creative Commons licenses. License are open licenses. In all licenses, CC refers to Creative Commons and BY is the attribution. Means one has to give credit irrespective of any license. So the first license is attribution, that is CC BY. This is attribution license which lets others to distribute, remix, tweak, and build upon your work, even commercially and non-commercially, as long as they give credit to you for the original creation. This is the most open license of all CC licenses. The next license is attribution share alike, that is BY-CC-SA. This is share alike license which lets others to adapt, remix, tweak, translate, and build upon your work even for commercially purpose, as long as they credit you and license their new creations under the identical terms, that is under the same license. This license is often compared to copyleft, that is free and open source software licenses. All new creation based on this license will carry the same license, also allow commercial use. Wikipedia also uses the same license, and is the open education resources also uses the same license. The next license is attribution no derivatives, or attribution non-derivatives, that is CC BY NA. Non-derivative condition in this license, as described earlier, protect your work from adapt, edit, and translate. One has to use it as such, what can exploit it commercially. What credit has to given only to you. The next is attribution non-commercial, that is CC BY NC. This license can let others to remix, tweak, and build upon your work even non-commercially only, and they must give credit or acknowledge for your work. The next license is the attribution non-commercial share alike, which is CC BY NC SA. Under this license, permission to remix, tweak, and build upon your work non-commercially has been granted, as long as they credit you. Share alike condition is a part of this license. The developed resources has to be released under similar license or under identical conditions along attribution to original creator of the content. The next license is attribution non-commercial non-derivative, that is CC BY NC ND. Under this license, one cannot edit, adopt, translate, or build upon your work, and also not able to commercially exploit it. What credit has to be given to you for using this work? This is the most restrictive of out of the six main licenses, and it is very difficult to use. Apart from these licenses, a large number of public domain content is available on the internet, which means the license for the content has been expired. As you must know, according to Indian Copyright Act, the term is of 60 years after the death of the original creator of the content or the copyright holder. After that, copyright will expire and the content will be a public property and available as a public domain content. Also, many reputed organizations like NASA, MIT, Oxford University, etc. release their content under public domain or any Creative Commons license for free use. The content or educational resources that are available under these open licenses are called open educational resources, as or technology saving teachers, one should know all aspects of open educational resources for using this content from the internet. The next is the open educational resources. Open education resources are the first choice of the teacher. What? The teacher should be able to understand the philosophy of OER and the way to share the content from the OER. As defined by UNESCO in 2002, OER defined as open education resources are teaching, learning, and research materials in any medium, digital or otherwise, that reside in the public domain or have been released under an open license that permits no cost access, use, adaptation, and redistribution by others or with no or limited restrictions. Once the content is available, the next task is to collate and curate the content for better dissemination. The learning management system, that is LMS, will help in that case. There are many free and openly available LMS like Moodle, Sakai, Ilias, or Tutor, Canvas, ELMS Learning Network, OpenEDX LMS, Camilo LMS, ClearLine Connect, Forma LMS, OLAT, etc. The office applications like word processor, spreadsheet, and presentation software will be helpful for teachers for typing and writing, analyzing, managing data, etc. The teachers should have command on various tools and software for data analysis. Since most of the learners are already equipped with different gadgets like smartphones, teachers has the opportunity to have online assessment. To do that, various portals and apps are available. Various video conferencing software can be used like Avview, Skype, Hangout, WhatsApp, etc. Online labs provide an opportunity for teachers and learners to perform experiments virtually. Now, let's discuss the various tools for techno-savvy teachers to be helpful for research endeavors. In research, articles play an important role, for which to visit a library is mandatory. What? The platforms like Google Scholars provide alerts for various research articles the moment they upload on the internet, even days or months before the library actually fetch a hard copy. The faculties should set up their profile and validate it with institutional email ID at scholars.google.com. The portals like ResearchGate, Academia, etc. are also very useful for getting research articles and to directly interact with authors, scientists working in similar fields. To acquire the managerial skills, the teachers can make use of online scheduler and calendars to streamline the things and keep them updated and the upcoming events and reminders about meetings. All your activities, events, reminders will be at one place. Today's students are collaborators. They can work together by using Google Apps for Education like Google Docs or Google Presentation to create something amazing remotely, and that's too without worrying about saving each other's data. Sharing presentation with teachers digitally by just a single click get the feedback instead of printing them out. In fact, many teachers utilize Turnitin softwares or other plagiarism software checkers mandating a digital Turnitin. However, file sharing goes both ways. Teachers can share class notes and other content with students and especially with absent ones and create a resource hub through various file storage tools. Whether they are taking advantage of Google Drive or using Dropbox, digital file sharing is a key skill for instructors. Tech-savvy teachers always welcome the tools that students use to communicate with each other and can also update the content on other portals for better dissemination to anyone. For their own professional development, teachers can opt for various MOOCs, that is massive open online courses freely available on the web and will be discussed in details in next module. Teachers can also make their own profile by using blogs and make their digital portfolios. The websites like sitesgoogle.com and blogspot.com and even the wordpress.com are very useful in these purposes. Teachers need to be aware of various cybersecurity issues for their own protection and also teach to their students about them. The teachers should be well versed with various plagiarism software to track content, authentic antivirus programs, spam, phishing, etc. Sharing too much personal information on the social media may lead to some problems. Now, let's discuss the various steps to become a techno-savvy teacher. Becoming a techno-savvy teacher requires a lot of dedication and enthusiasm. Irrespective, you are a beginner or an expert and intend to learn a new technology. Now we will discuss the few of the steps or ways that one can adopt. You can begin with thrilling journey. The first might be the communication, that is communicated by using digital technologies. Electronic communication is the most used method the people use to communicate. You need to have an understanding of sending emails and messages. Learn to use group features on messaging apps and make a group of your own students to whom you want to broadcast the same messages. Learn and use admin settings to regulate the groups. Flexibility to adapt and embrace new technology. Technology keeps changing every day. You need to be open to these changes and adapt to them as and when they came. Acceptance of such changes will keep you ahead of many of your colleagues and fellows. The next one, go paperless. Assessment is inseparable part of any teaching learning process and also took a lot of time to collect, manage, check and analyze the data. These tedious tasks can be performed by a tech-savvy teachers by using the technologies. No need for paper assessment. Online assessment by using computer or mobile make it easier for teacher to perform and analyze the data. One such example you must have tried in previous module like Kahoot. Even student can also submit the PDF on the cloud and share with teachers for checking. Teachers also share the presentation, extra notes with students to save the classroom timing. The next one is the online educational apps. In earlier days, we used to have separate computer lab in schools. Nowadays, every classroom looks like a computer lab where each student has a laptop for learning. Learning through apps is widely increased, hence, if you wish to be tech-savvy, you need to learn to use these apps. Today's teacher need to understand these interfaces thoroughly as students are all about e-learning. Especially when it comes to taking extra classes such as maths, physics or chemistry. Students prefer online learning from the comfort of their home. The next skill is the use of social media. Social media is another platform which any tech-savvy person can needs to be master. It is the future of any field. As majority of the learners are using social media, the teachers should also be there to tap this resource for teaching learning process. The potential of Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, etc. are more than just a medium of entertainment. Making a close group on social media is a great way of being in touch with your class and communicate all class-related activities. Although the platform like YouTube are flooded with content, but quality and authenticity of the content is always a matter of concern. The teacher can create their own YouTube channel and upload their subject-related teaching videos. Social media provides endless possibilities for teaching and learning. The best quality of a tech-savvy teacher is to dig deep into these endless possibilities of social media and make best use of it. The next skill is the use of digital assessment. Technology has made thousands of activities easier and less time-consuming than it used to be. One such best example is the use of digital assessment to save time and efforts. Multiple choice questions can be easily assessed and marked. Most of the entrance exams use a digital assessment to evaluate thousands of papers. You can introduce these format in your classroom to save the time. The next is the most important and need of the hour is the go global. Technology has made the entire globe as accessible to you through communication. Why teach locally if you can go global? to communicate and collaborate with other teachers across the globe is just like one click away, and to learn from them also. Being tech-savvy is not just need in today's education system, but in every technology helps to you in using a better approach of teaching, which motivates the students and elevates their learnings. The next one is use of blogs and portals to communicate with students. An info-savvy teacher is always helpful and within reach of his or her students. Tech-savvy teacher not only make use of best technologies in classroom, but also make this learning experience out of a class. And by writing new ideas on blogs and portals, he or she ignite the minds of learners and ask for their feedback and sharing of knowledge. Students can learn more in these non-traditional manners. The next skill, which is the most important, that is a lifelong learning. The best quality of a tech-savvy teacher is to learn new skills with the changing time. If there is new technology, software, or portal to be helpful for teaching learning, he or she will learn all about it. Always try their hands on new gadgets. The next one is making classroom as world theater. Techno-savvy teachers always try to bring an entire world within the classroom to make learning more comfortable and engaging. For example, by using the tools like online maps, virtual tours in Street View to teach the concept in geography, using various simulations, animation to understand the concept in science. If one intends to be tech-savvy teacher, one has to acquire these skills to evolve your classroom and give your student a whole new learning experience in this ever-expanding digitized world. Now finally, we'll discuss the habits of a tech-savvy teacher. The first one is the flexibility. Technology is constantly changing, as we described earlier, and evolving. The tech-savvy teacher also able to adapt to these changes as needed. Tech-savvy teachers always have a sense of techniques, mainly to troubleshoot the things and always be ready with plan B and even sometime with plan C when things don't go the way they have planned earlier. The next is digital communication. In this digitized world, every bit of information is being shared every second. Tech-savvy teachers should be comfortable with email and social media posts, and they intuitively understand how to use these tools appropriately and effectively to disseminate the information. Adapt change. These teachers do more than simply tolerate big change. Usually, they are ones pursuing it, bringing new innovations to their schools and districts and even to the classrooms. The next one is the long-range goal in mind. Tech-savvy teachers don't just do the things for the sake of technology. They should understand, deploy, and also can articulate the technology to advance their own goals for education. The next one, they use technology in their day-to-day life. Tech-savvy teachers not only use technology at work, but also use it for their everyday activities like shopping, banking, and making plans with friends, etc. The next one, tech balancing life, which is very important. As much as tech-savvy teachers love technology, they also keep a balance and realize that it isn't everything. Good technology can help a teacher, but does not automatically make a good teacher. Besides, everyone needs a break from technology sometime and balances their life with other activities and get together. The next, cloud or paper, you have to choose it. Tech-savvy teachers always try to avoid paper wastage. Collecting and grading paper-based assessment is always their concern. Tech-savvy teachers make best use of cloud technology to assign, collect, and grade students' work. The next thing is collaborate. Tech-savvy teachers always want to share their skills and ideas to fellows and learn from them. They always enthusiastic for learning new technical skills. They even collaborate with teachers in other parts of the globe with the available technologies. The next one, digital assessment. A number of apps and portals are available for various purposes. What tech-savvy teachers always know, basic requirement to adapt them to in their classroom, and these apps will best meet their learning objectives. The next one is using the different mobile apps. As technology always advances, why stick to just with the old ones? This needs to be upgraded with time. Teachers will use different apps depending on their subject and the level of their students. So, everybody is enthusiastic about technology and using it for their own purpose. What being a teacher to help the students in technology is a big issue. Using right technology for right pedagogy is the job of a good info-savvy or tech-savvy teacher. And I hope that this module will help in inculcating the tech-savvy skills in you. Hope you have enjoyed the modules. Thank you.